The God that caused Hannah to laugh. The God that caused Sarah to laugh. This same God that caused the children of Israel to laugh will cause you to laugh. This is your time.
I'm waiting for our learning. Romans 5:15, for that we through patience and comfort of Scripture might have hope. The reason why certain things are documented in Scripture for us to see that if God did this one, then he can do another one. So it's very important for us to understand. Israel had been in captivity for many years. God spoke that they would go to captivity for 70 years, and 70 is enough period of time for people to become acclimatized with their situation. There are some of you here who are so used to your condition. In fact, you are coming to church. You are coming to church, you are committed, you are dedicated. As a matter of fact, you have forgotten about your situation. For you, God is not ready to touch my life. But I was sent to Baltimore, to the house of praise, specifically for you. Whatever that you is in your life, I declare it destroyed. I declare it destroyed. The devil has lied in your life. Whatever is unspoken can never come to pass. God's thoughts towards you are thoughts of peace, not of evil, to give you an expected end. Ever before you came on the scene, glory had been determined as your destiny. For he who made it for no, he did predestined to be conformed to the image of his son, that he may be firstborn among many brethren. When God is ready, when God says this is the best time for you, you see, some of you want to leave when you will not be celebrated. What's the use of Joseph coming out of prison when there is no position for him? All things work together for good to them that love God, to them that are the called according to his purpose. Glory to God. When I love it when it is God's timing. See, when God, the Lord, you see, this is not about man. It's not about how good you are. It's not about your credentials. It's God's own initiative and decision. You see, one of the things we Christians must learn is this: don't come to God based on your credentials. Your credentials are not good enough. Praise God. Lord, you see, I have given too much. Lord, you see, I'm praising you. Lord, you see, I am fasting. Lord, you see, I'm paying my tithe. We do all those things. It's good. It's part of our Christian assignment. Lord, you see, I come to church and I'm more regular in church than even God himself. So, God, if there's anyone you must bless, it must be me. Wrong man. That's a wrong credential. It's juju. Because ever before you arrived on the scene, Jesus has paid the price. Are you hearing me? It's about Jesus. The Bible says, while we were yet sinners, he died. It's not about us. Christianity is not about you trying to do certain things so that God will accept you. We got it mixed up and twisted. That's religion. What can I do so that God will love me? What can I do so that I will be acceptable to God? What can I do so that I get it? Oh, it's about what God has already done for you in Christ that makes you acceptable to him. He is the one who does the work. And you hear what I'm telling you? When you understand this, it changes your entire perspective. Your serving God will change. In fact, you will go bananas for God. When you understand, it's not about Jesus, it's about him. He who knew no sin became sin, that we may be made the righteousness of God in Christ. For you know the grace of God, that even though he was rich, he became poor, that we through his poverty might be rich. He did no sin, knew no sin, no sin was found in him. Yet, he took on my sin. He took it on so that I can have access into the throne of grace. That's why the Bible says, Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace and obtain mercy and find grace for help at every time of need. It's about him. It's about him. If you understand this, struggle will end. No fretting, no fear. You are not guilty, you are not condemned, you are not accused. Rather, you rest that God has loved you with everlasting love. Hallelujah. You'll be surprised how many people don't know that the God will never be mad at them again. Many people don't know that. So the struggle continues. And I want to please God. You can please him. It is the one that will make you please him. Are you hearing me? Do you understand the mystery in the scripture that says, if any man be, is a new, all things have become what? All you need to do is to become in Christ. When you are in Christ, dead, every other thing is settled. Because God sees you in Christ. Not in yourself. Somebody understanding? The Christed life settles it. And I am so joyful because he did it all. It's not about me. The day I received Jesus into my life, everything changed. Everything about my past, present, and future, guaranteed. I don't wake up looking for the devil. With the devil. It's not around. What I carry is too much. The Bible says true knowledge are the just to believe. Proverbs 11 are true knowledge. When you receive knowledge, then some of you losing sleep. Over nothing. Do you think that God is contending with the devil? Look at him. What's wrong with you? The last time I checked, God is laughing. With all that the devil does here on earth, God is sitting down laughing. He's not, he has never gotten up from his seat and wondering, what am I going to do with this devil? No. Understand your authority. You are too loaded to fail. Glory to God. I said glory to God. If any man be in, so you have your offering pocket. Where's your offering pocket? And your offering pocket there. Yes, give it to me. Just give me the pocket or the bag there. If any man be, let me just give you a simple illustration. This is Jesus. When you receive Jesus to your life, if any man be, the experience of this basket becomes your experience. Anywhere this basket goes, the handkerchief inside it goes. If this basket is destroyed, then you can destroy the handkerchief. But if it cannot be destroyed, neither can you be destroyed. Your life is in the Christ in God. Somebody shout hallelujah. I said shout hallelujah. That's why I can look at you and declare that no sickness will destroy you. I rebuke every sickness. I rebuke every disease. Cancerous growth in your life, I curse it now. I curse it now. I speak to your heart, I speak to your kidney, I speak to your liver, I speak to your bones and marrow, your bloodstreams right now. I command them, be healed in the name of Jesus. 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 The devil has no right to keep you back. When the it is orchestrated by him.
The Lord!
I'm not talking about man. Man has limitation, but God has no limitation.